Now what I'm demonstrating is the latest refractive lenticule-based procedure, which is the Silk procedure. We start with marking the toric axis for the patient. At the moment, the cyclotorsion is manual, but very soon we're gonna have the automated cyclotorsion in the Elita machine. Using the slit lamp to do the marking, very convenient in my hands. Before we do the marking, we make sure that the slit is perfectly bisecting the two pupils and the head is nicely aligned. Now, completing the first step, after the marking, we ship the patient to the Elita Silk machine. So this is how the machine looks like. It has a small footprint, doesn't occupy too much of a space. I'm showing you the parameters here. So we are correcting about 5 diopters of sphere with about half a cylinder. For the ease of visibility and recording, I'm demonstrating only the left hand. So now the patient is on the bed. So I've kept the machines independent. You also have an option of attaching the machine with a common bed with the excimer laser, but I prefer to keep it independent so that all the machines can be used at every time. Now, putting the speculum onto the patient's eye. The beauty of this Elita machine is that you can use it without the speculum also. But for beginners, I recommend using the speculum, and I feel very comfortable with the speculum on. So now the eyes is nice and centered, and we proceed with the next step. Now, this is how the PI, patient interface, looks like. So it's a two-piece interface. The first is the cone which goes on to the laser head, and the second is the suction ring. Now, the beauty of the newer J&J machines is that the suction is now automated, unlike the older machine where the suction was manual. So this goes in onto the machine, nice and ready. Now, before we start the procedure, make sure that the cornea is nicely clean, and any meibom debris or any kind of other debris is properly removed. Now, we place the suction ring onto the eye. At the moment, it is two-piece, but very soon we are going to have a single-piece suction PI. But I'm still very comfortable with the two-piece because, number one, it gives you better control. Number two, there is no uprolling, so you prevent a lot of vertical comas. And number three, it's a strong suction. So till date, I've not had even a single case of suction loss. So the machine docks like a breeze. It is nice and easy, very low learning curve. And once the machine is docked, we start setting the parameters on the screen. So we align the cyclotorsion with the axis mark that we put on the slit lamp. We center the ablation area. So you can do it on pupil center also, you can do it on visual axis center also, that's not a problem. Taking a zone of 6 millimeter, the optic zone, and keeping transition zone of 7.6 millimeter with an opening of 3.5. And we are good to start about 17.3 seconds. So the laser has started. So first it makes the posterior plane, then it makes the ring cut, and now it is making the anterior plane nice and smooth, and then it makes the entry cut. That's it, 17 seconds, nice and done. Now we shift the patient under a microscope. So undocking, this part is done. Throughout the procedure, it's comfortable. Patient doesn't feel too much of a pressure. So I've organized the operation theater that we finish up with the first machine, and then we shift the patient to the EX500 examiner machine, and we are using the microscope of that machine. So opening the entry cut now. And understand it's a biconvex lenticule. So we go in, slightly at an angle to open the anterior plane, and then we open the posterior plane. And now just look at the beauty of this procedure. There is a reason why it is called silk, because the dissection is virtually slipping your instrument through the interface. It is actually like silk. The name really stands relevant to the technology. Anterior plane done, posterior plane done. Works like breeze, works like magic. You have little additions on the 3 o'clock, 9 o'clock position, which keeps the lenticule in center. Go inside, grab it, and just pull it out. So for the initial 50 to 100 cases, I recommend checking the lenticule. But with experience, you get to know that in case there is a difficult dissection, then you check it. Otherwise, you can just proceed. I have this habit of cleaning the interface properly, washing the interface so that there is no debris, no lint inside. And then this is the most important part. This is called ironing, just to make sure there are no Bowman folds. And then soft ironing, nice and smooth, and that's it. The procedure is done. A drop of antibiotic and we are good to go. Next day morning, usually 90% of the patients are 6'6", about 10% are 6'9", 6'6" part, and in 2 to 3 days, patient is good to start anything and everything. Thank you so much.